life was falling apart. I felt I was surrounded by darkness. Hope was a distant memory. I didn't know where to turn. I called the church, and they told me about Stephen ministry. Prayerfully, I waited for my Stephen minister to call me. I wondered what she would be like, if I would be able to relate to her. How could she ever help me? It was like I picked someone just for me. We talked a lot. She listened to me. She accepted me and prayed for me. She never gave up on me during the ugliest times of my life. I was ready to quit, but she never stopped praying and hoping. You know, I met God in a powerful way through my Stephen minister. I really felt God's love through her. All I can say is, thank you.
Stephen ministers come alongside a person at a time in their life when they are in a difficult transition from loss or turmoil. We extend the hand of Christ in a very tangible way to that person. Stephen ministers make a formal commitment to work in a lay ministry of the church. Through the training we receive, we are given enhanced, caring life skills. We offer acceptance and encouragement based on a reliance on God and prayer. Ours is a confidential listening and connecting relationship. We offer mercy, patience, and humility, those quiet gifts that work behind the scenes to help people. We don't feel pressured to come up with solutions. We know that it is our Lord who will do the healing. Each of you has the opportunity to extend the hand of Christ. Become a Stephen minister.
Good morning, Good Shepherd, and welcome to the garden again this day. As we worship together, I want to give thanks that you have come together to worship with me this morning. If you are new to us, we are just thrilled that you have chosen to come and be a part of our virtual worship today. We are continuing our series this day on digging deep, finding what it means to get closer to God in our faith. Today, in our garden metaphor, we're going to be talking about fertilizing our spirits and the ways that God calls us to do that. So I invite you now into this time of worship and ask that you would join me in this prayer. Oh, Holy God, we just thank you for the ability to come to worship you in this way. We are grateful that you meet us exactly where we are and that you long to help us to grow deeper. We just ask now that you would open our hearts, minds, and spirits to receive that which you have prepared for us in this time ahead. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Brian is going to start us off by singing Because of Your Love. I want to invite you to stand where you are, if you're able to engage in this time of worship and to feel God's Spirit move.
So amazing, Lord, we've come to give you thanks for all you've done. Because of your love, we're forgiven. Because of your love, our hearts are clean. We lift you up, songs of freedom, forever with your love. As we come into your presence, we remember every blessing that you poured out so freely from above. Lifting gratitude and praises for compassion. compassion so amazing. Lord, we've come to give you thanks for all you've done. Because of your love, we're forgiven. Because of your love, our hearts are free. We lift you up, the songs of freedom.
Good morning, friends. I hope you all had an amazing, blessed week. Blessings. I've been thinking a lot about the way we use the word bless in our everyday conversation. We say it when someone sneezes, bless you. And we talk about blessings on holidays. Your time with family is such a blessing. Blessings come up a lot, but what are they exactly? That's what you'll be talking about in Sunday school today. Whatever they are, Rebecca wanted them for Jacob. After all, that's the way God said it would be. So she took it upon herself to make sure Isaac blessed Jacob and not his twin brother Esau. Yet God was still in control, and he still worked through this messy family. But again, you'll be hearing more about that later. Sometimes, like Rebecca and Jacob, we forget the source from whom all blessings flow, and try to manipulate blessings into existence on our own. But we don't need to. Instead, we can trust God, because God is in control. So to get ready for our lesson this week, I want you to think about a time where you felt like everything was out of control. And then think about how God helped you through that situation. Say a prayer, or write a prayer, or draw a prayer, thanking God for blessing you. Because sometimes giving help is a way for God to bless us and thank God for staying in control in our lives. So here, I'll start. You join with me in prayer? Dear God, thank you for being the source of our blessings and for keeping us safe during this pandemic. We might feel like the world is out of control, but we know that you are the one guiding the hands of first responders, nurses, doctors, and scientists. We know that you are the one helping our parents, our teachers, our pastor, and our friends, and us. Please continue to guide and bless us, and continue to help us see all the little reminders that you are in control. In your name we pray. Amen.
No. morning, Good Shepherd. Welcome back to our garden. If you listen to Jesus when he teaches, you'll often hear him refer to the objects around him. Maybe he saw a bush or a tree or a bird as he was teaching, and like the master storyteller that he was, he wove it right into the tale he was telling. Of course, the people that he was talking to tended to be from the rural areas of Palestine, and they would have maybe been farmers or gardeners and recognized the references he made to fields, flowers, gardens, trees, birds, and so on. Our scripture readings from today come from Luke's gospel, and both of them are examples of what I'm talking about. Our first reading is from Luke chapter 6, verses 43 to 45. The context here is the Sermon on the Plain. This is similar material, but maybe not identical to maybe what is more familiar to us, the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew's gospel. Verse 43 says that no good tree bears bad fruit, nor again does a bad tree bear good fruit. For each tree is known by its own fruit. Figs are not gathered from thorns, nor are grapes picked from a bramble bush. The good person, out of the good treasure of the heart, produces good. And likewise, the evil person, out of evil treasure, produces evil. For it is out of the abundance of the heart that the mouth speaks. Our second reading is from Luke 13, verses 6 and 7. And this comes from the parable of the barren fig tree. Then he told them this parable. A man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came looking for fruit on it and found none. So he said to the gardener, "See here, for 3 years I've come looking for fruit on this fig tree, and still I find none. Cut it down. Why should it waste the soil?" The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Rachel.
prepare to hear God's word this morning, will you pray with me? Oh, holy God, you meet us this morning in the garden, promising that you will walk with us each step of the way. You ask us to turn to you to receive all the nutrients that we need, that we might grow deeper in faith with you. Oh, Lord God, may we indeed meet you here and receive all that you have to give. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, I do want to welcome you back to the garden today. I'm here sitting in front of our vegetable garden. We have some tomatoes, and we have some cucumbers and some squash. I'm looking forward to being able to harvest this in just a little bit. We were slightly later getting started with our garden. We have a hard time finding a particularly perfect spot at our house where we get good morning sun. And so we've tried this year. I'll let you know how it goes. Well, today, as we're in the garden, we're going to be talking about fertilizing our faith for deep growth. Management of soil fertility has been the preoccupation of farmers for thousands of years. Egyptians and Romans and Babylonians and early Germans are all recorded as having used minerals and or manure to enhance the productivity of their farms. Simply put, fertilizers enhance the growth of plants. This goal is met in two ways. The traditional one being that the additives provide nutrients, and the second mode is that the fertilizers act to enhance the effectiveness of the soil by modifying its water retention and aeration. The development of synthetic nitrogen in more recent days has significantly supported global population growth. It is estimated that almost half of the people on the earth are currently fed as a result of synthetic nitrogen fertilizer use. The use of phosphate fertilizers has also increased from 9 million tons per year in 1960 to over 40 million tons per year in 2020. A corn crop yielding 6 to 9 tons of grain per hectare, or 2.5 acres, requires 68 to 110 pounds of phosphate fertilizer to be applied. That's amazing. Well, many home gardeners have taken to creating their own fertilizer supplies, in some ways to avoid some of these synthetic means, and they do this through compost piles. By placing old bananas and eggshells and grass clippings and coffee grounds and other kitchen scraps into an outdoor compost pile, a very rich fertilizer can be created over time. Now, I want you to keep that image in mind with you throughout this sermon, because when we come back to the end, you're going to hear more about that. Well, the goal of gardening is to bear good fruit, whether that be actual fruit or vegetables like the ones behind me or plants. In our first week, we talked about how important soil was for bearing that fruit. We said for a good garden to take root, that soil needs to be overturned and roots and debris is cleared away. Last week, we talked about irrigation as a necessary part of the garden. The regular practices of watering, which spiritually we talked about with worship and personal study and prayer, and then participating in carrying that water to particularly children who have not taken firm root yet in faith. Today, I want to talk to us about fertilizing our faith in a way that will allow deeper roots and more fruit. Because we don't just want to bear a little bit of fruit. We want to bear a lot of fruit for God's kingdom. And if we want to bear good fruit and lots of it, we have to do the inner work of nourishing our souls with lots of different nutrients. In his Sermon on the Plain, where Jesus teaches people, we read, on a level place, instructing them about God's blessings and human relationships and ethics, Jesus says, "No good tree bears bad fruit, nor does a bad tree bear good fruit. Each tree is recognized by its own fruit." Jesus is saying that what is inside of us gets born out on the outside of us. Who we are on the inside bears fruit or not. So we have to work to make sure of what is on the inside so that we can be known for bearing good fruit. Now, you know, it's been said that plants need different kinds of nutrients to grow. There are three main nutrients in fertilizer. They're typically nitrogen, which creates leaf growth, phosphorus, which helps to develop the roots, and potassium, which allows for strong stem growth, and also protecting the plants against disease so that they can have good flowering and bear good fruit. For most plants, a balance of these nutrients is ideal. Gardeners refer to this as the NPK ratio. Now, different plants require a bit of a different ratio. And experienced gardeners are able to assess what is needed for the plants that they are trying to grow. They are also able to gauge when fertilizer is needed in the life cycle of a plant. Alan tells me, for example, that he typically waits a couple of weeks before adding fertilizer to flower gardens that he has just planted. He feels that the plants need some time to take root before they can truly use the added minerals well. He warned that if you either add too much fertilizer or if you add it too soon, you can burn up the plants that you're trying to grow. Well, the human spirit is not unlike plants in that it needs the right balance of nutrients to grow, spiritual minerals, as it were. Last week, we talked about the basics of irrigation with worship and daily prayer, study, and watering the lives of others. But for us to grow deeper, we need to go deeper. And we need a variety of spiritual nutrients that are balanced in a way that will help us to thrive. Jesus tells a parable about a man who has a fig tree growing in his vineyard. And he goes out to look for fruit on it, but he doesn't find any. So he says to the man in charge of caring for the vineyard, "For 3 years now, I've been coming to this fig tree to find fruit, and I haven't found any. Cut it down. Why should it use up the soil?" Well, the gardener says, "Sir, leave it alone for one more year, and let me dig around it and fertilize it. And if it bears fruit next year, fine. If not, then we'll cut it down." Jesus uses this parable to talk about the need of our spirits to be fertilized. The fig tree was not bearing fruit. It had been in the man's garden for 3 years and nothing had come from it. The owner of the garden wanted to cut it down and use the space for something else to grow. But the one who was tending the garden said, "Let me dig deep and fertilize this tree and let me give it more time." So, what is the nutrient balance that we need to grow well and to bear fruit? Because, you know, God longs to have us have that. To follow the NPK ratio, we need things that will help us grow leaves, strengthen our roots, and produce fruit. I want to suggest to us that we need to have an FSO balance, as it were. Fellowship, small groups and Bible study, and outreach. Fellowship is a key ingredient to the health of our spiritual faith and that of our faith community. We need one another. And by being in one another's presence, even if virtually, we encourage one another to turn to the Son, Jesus the Christ. And in that encouragement, our spiritual leaves will grow. For example, we every week have an opportunity called Fellowship at 5 via Zoom. If you've not been a part of that, I want to invite you to do that. There are other groups like the Prayer Weavers and Saturday Night Live and, of course, Youth Ministry. All of these are important growing places. But if our roots are to go deeper and grow stronger, we also must learn to study together. We recently sent out a questionnaire asking for interest in forming covenant groups. Now, a number of you have responded and you're in the process of forming these groups. This is part of our Wesleyan heritage, to form such groups where we grow together in covenant relationship with God and with one another. If you have not yet signed up for this and you want to, I want to encourage you to email our admin, it's on the screen there for you, and express your interest in that. Other small group activities include Sunday morning Sunday school for adults and children. The adult class is meeting by Zoom at 11:30 every Sunday morning. The link is in the newsletter or available again from our admin. The Children's Sunday School is offered via YouTube every Sunday, and the link is on our Facebook and web pages. Katie Lutz is doing a fabulous job leading this, and I want to encourage those of you with young children and families to check it out and to recommend that to other children. Another wonderful way to go deeper with our spiritual nutrients is through the Emmaus community. While there are not currently walks scheduled for this fall, unfortunately, there will be more in the future. And I want to encourage you, if you've walked in the past, there are reunion groups that meet weekly, and you are encouraged to be a part of them. Again, if you want more information on this, you can reach out to our admin and she'll put you in touch with those who can help you to be part of a current group. There's also a Thursday evening Bible study that folks both from the Emmaus community and others join together with. And the information about that is also in the newsletter. Well, no matter what, doing a deep dive through study and small groups is vitally important for our roots to grow stronger. And we may need a variety of study opportunities, just as plants need a variety of nutrients. The third nutrient is outreach. When we understand that God has created us in a way that we are nourished and grow when we give of ourselves, we understand how important outreach is. Next week, we're going to wrap up this series by talking about the kinds of fruits that God calls us to bear and the ways that we are called to share them. But for today, know that outreach is indeed part of fertilizing our spirit. Think back to that compost pile that I mentioned at the beginning. We take the fruit that we bear and we sow it into the world. And from that comes richer nutrients that can in turn be sown into the world to produce even more fruit. It is a cycle that we are meant to be a part of. We're composting faith, as it were. So let me give you some examples of ways that you can be a part of outreach in our church. You can volunteer at Our Place Feeding Ministry. You can help Katie by becoming a virtual Sunday school teacher 1 week this summer. You can commit to becoming a Stephen minister who will be a caring friend for those in our church community who really need that. A new class will be starting in August and it will be done virtually. There's information in the newsletter about that and how you can become a part of that. And as our children go back to school virtually, as I said last week, there's going to be a need for persons to serve as mentors and tutors for families and children. If that is something you would be willing to do to help a student or a family, please let me know. I'm developing a list of persons right now who would be willing to be a support system to families as they try to balance work and education in the months ahead. Each week of this series, I have been asking us, how is it with your soul? I want to ask us this question again today. And I want to ask this question as well. What fertilizer does your soul need right now? Do you need to connect with others in fellowship to overcome the socially distanced blues? Do you need to join a small group to help you grow and be accountable for that growth? Do you need to find ways to help others so that you will see the amazing gifts that God has placed within you? What is the FSO ratio that your spirit needs right now? Because God wants you to grow. God is that gardener standing by your fig tree of a spirit saying, I will dig down deeper and I will offer you nutrients to help you to grow and to bear fruit. You heard me say that we are a little bit late planting our vegetable garden this year. But God says it's never truly too late to nourish our gardens. Because God stands ready to help us to grow. And so it is my prayer for all of us that we will do the work that we need to do to receive the beautiful gift of a spirit that bears fruit in the name of Jesus the Christ. Let it be so. Amen and amen. Brian's now going to lead us in singing a beautiful song called Morning is Broken. Let us sing it together, giving thanks that God walks in the garden with us, fresh and new every single day.
Singing praise for the morning, praise for the springing fresh from the world. Sweet the rain's new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet pass. Mine is the sun. God's recreation of the new day.
Happy Sunday, church. Let's take this time to share our joys and concerns with each other. I can't tell you what a joy it is for me to make these calls to our congregation, and that even in these difficult times, we can still find joy. Jim, Janie, and Kathy Slagle's joy was to visit with Jimmy, Stacy, Trey, and Tyler. They celebrated Trey's 18th birthday, worshiped together virtually with Good Shepherd and Northside Baptist, and shared the communion given to them by Good Shepherd with the family. The Katumno family, John, Sarah, and their son Isaac, are celebrating answered prayers. John's brother Paul, who lives in Florida, is recovering from COVID and addiction. It will be a healing journey for both circumstances, but still a joy that recovery is happening. Nancy Dutton's granddaughters, Lila 3, and Zoe, brings such joy to her. She got to visit Zoe last September when she was 3.5 months old, and she has just turned a year old. They are beautiful, and I could feel Nancy's smile and joy through the phone. The Carr family, Dana, Mike, Christian, Nathaniel, and Elizabeth, are celebrating the fact that Christian was elevated to the highest award in Boy Scouts of America by receiving his Eagle Scout badge. The ceremony at church was derailed by COVID, but it didn't dampen the magnitude of the award. Congratulations, Christian. Lord, now hear our prayers for these concerns. Danny Gazi, husband of Lori, is recovering from heart surgery, and their daughter is having health issues as well. Dave and Sandy Taylor. Our first responders, to include firefighters, police officers, and EMTs. All those suffering with COVID-19, those medical personnel who are caring for them, and the scientists searching for treatment and vaccines. Service men and women serving throughout the world for the cause of freedom. We pray for all our leaders at every level. Give them wisdom, strength, and hope. For the healing of the wounds of racism in our country. Our educators, students, and families, as decisions are being made about the start of school, including our own Good Shepherd Education Center. Let us lift these prayers. Gracious and loving God, we humbly come before you this day as members of your Holy Church family to give you thanks, honor, and praise. Come and refresh us. Let it be a time of renewal. Breathe new life into us. Help us to be a people overflowing with faith, courage, and hope. Let us see your divine image stamped in every human being so that we may treat one another with kindness, dignity, and respect. Embolden us to work for peace in our homes, congregations, communities, and world. Send us to act with compassion and love among those who are suffering in all circumstances. Remind us, O God, that while we cannot do everything, we can do something. Make us reflections of you. Enable us to embody your grace and love so that by our service, we may know the joy and meaning that comes from caring for one another. Help us to listen for your voice above all others, reminding us that nothing is more important than your love. Let us be united in Christ. Lord, hear all these prayers, spoken and unspoken, as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. May God be with you until we meet again.
It is that time in the service that we give to God that which is God's. I want to remind you this morning that we are doing our drive-through Sunday from 10:30 to 11:30 this morning, and you are invited to come and to receive Holy Communion for next Sunday, to receive prayer from me and from lay leader Bud Campbell, and also to give. If you have an offering that you want to give, you may do that this Sunday morning at church, and you also can bring items that are needed for our place today. They are specifically in need of beverages that they can hand out in this very hot weather. Water and sports drinks are the most preferred at this time. So if you're able to do that, anything you can give will be a help. They're also asking for some small packaged foods like Vienna sausages, and also things like ramen and Chef Boyardee meals that people can take easily and eat easily without having to do much to them. So if you're able to do those things, it would be much appreciated. 10:30 to 11:30 this morning, you are most welcome to do that. Will you pray with me as we give thanks for all that God has given to us? Oh, holy God, you sow into our lives day after day so many blessings. You nourish us with so many gifts. As we give back to you this morning, Lord God, we just ask that you would help us to use all that you have given us well to produce fruit in this world, fruit that lasts and points to your love and grace. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Our closing song from Brian this day is "I Shall Not Be Moved." Will you get up off your seats where you are as you're able and join in singing together?
hallelujah, I shall not be moved. Anchored in Jehovah, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the water, I shall not be moved. In his love abiding, I shall not be moved. And in him confiding, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the water, I shall not be moved. I shall not be, I shall not be moved. I shall not be, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the water, I shall not be moved. Though all hail assail me, I shall not be moved. Jesus will not fail me, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the water, I shall not be moved. Though the tempest rages, I shall not be moved. On the rock of ages, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the water, I shall not be moved. I shall not be, I shall not be moved. I shall not be, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the water, I shall not be moved.
What a beautiful day of worship it has been. I hope that you have been touched by God's presence in new ways, and that you are indeed being challenged to grow deeper in your faith. Will you receive now this benediction as we close our time out together? Oh Lord, even as we have spent time with you this morning in the garden, may we go forward to receive the nutrients that you, our gardener, wants to spread into our spirits. May we turn our lives over to you that we might grow deeper. Let us go in God's grace. Let us go in God's peace. Thanks be to God. Amen.
And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy